Let's take a look at another sampling technique known as systematic 1 in K random sampling. Now, you must know cap N and little n. And as a reminder, capital N equals the population size, and little n equals the sample size. In a simple random sample, if you're using technology, you also had to know capital N. If you weren't using technology, if everybody put their number on a poker chip that represented them, or their name on a poker chip, threw it in a big box, you don't need to know how many are in there to just shake it up and pull out a simple random sample. But if you're using technology, then for a simple random sample, because you need to tell it where to stop, then you would need to know capital N. Now here's the idea. We're going to partition a population into N partitions. A partition is just a group. Each of size K, and we're going to have to actually calculate K. And K equals capital N over little n. So these partition sizes, these group sizes, equals the population size divided by the sample size. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk through the process here and kind of explain it, and then I'm going to whip through an example with some numbers so you can follow me. Now once you have this K, this is what we refer to as K, we're going to truncate. So if this turns out to be 27.215 whatever, doesn't matter what's to the right of the decimal, we're going to truncate, we're going to get rid of it, and we're going to use 27 for our groups. And again, I will walk through with numbers actually show this process in just a moment. Now what you can do is go to the starting point and take a sample. The starting point is this random start. You need a random number, a random integer between 1 and k, which this really quick example is 27. Let's just say it was 13. So that means you go to 13 and take your sample. Maybe this is a list, or maybe this it's a location on a plot of land or something. So you go to 13, take your sample, then add 27 to it. Well, what you just did is by adding 27, you just went to the 13th location in the second group. Take your sample, add 27. Well, that means you went to the 13th location in the third group, and so forth. And you keep going, sampling every k elements, adding that 27 in this quick example, until you complete your sample. So let's just, let's go ahead and work on an example, and I'll kind of draw it out as we're going here. Let's just say our population happens to be, 529. It's a very small population. And let's just say as an example that N equals 47. So I can afford to get a sample of 47 out of this population. So what I need to do is grab a calculator or some piece of technology, or do it by longhand if you want, I don't care. And I'm going to need to find K. K equals 529 divided by 47, which equals 11.25, and some more I don't really care. I'm going to truncate and say K is 11. Well, this is what I just got done doing. Here is the first person or object, the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, tenth, 11, 12, 13, say 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, say 30, 31, 32, 33, 34th, out to the 529th. Well, my groups are 11. So this is group 1, 11 more, 22, that's group 3, or group 2, 11 more, that's 33, that's group 3. And so forth. So I just broke this whole group or this whole population into 47 groups of 11, except for the last group. Because we truncated here, this last group could have like 12 or 13 or something. It depends on what the actual values are. This last group could be slightly bigger. But the reason we truncated is, let's just pretend that this came out to rather than 11.25, let's just say it's 11.71, and you rounded up and went to 12. Well, the problem is when you multiply 47 by 12, it's more than 529. So this is what could happen. I'm going to find this random start. So I reach for a calculator, some form of technology, and I tell it to find a random integer no smaller than 1, no bigger than, in this case, 12. So I have these groups of 12. And let's just suppose that I ended up with 11 as my random start. Well, if I did that and I went to the 11th number, and now just pretend for a moment that each of these groups has groups of 12, when I get to the very end, I could be looking for number 531 or 532 that doesn't even exist. By truncating and going to 11, just using an integer value, now let's say I have a random start, and let's say that random start happens to be 11. Well, that means that my first sample would be the 11th person. Add 11 more, I go to the 22nd. Add 11 more, I go to the 33rd. When I'm done, 47 times 11 is 517, so I'm going to end up at 517, which is in here. On the other hand, if I had that 12, I'd be looking for number 564, which doesn't exist. So by truncating, getting rid of that decimal, that is going to help ensure that this problem doesn't happen. My last sample will be guaranteed to be inside of what actually exists. So now that I've identified which ones to go get, if this was in a list, maybe I'm going through a list of people and I'm calling them, I would go to the 11th one, make a phone call, go to the 22nd, make a phone call. I'm just going to keep adding 11 to it, go to the 33rd, make a phone call, go to the 44th, make a phone call, and so forth. Now, if this random start happened to be, say, a 4, then I will go to the 4th one, make a phone call. 11 plus 4 is 15, so I go to the 15th one, make a phone call. Add 11 more to it, that would get me into this next group. Well, 15 and 11 is 26, so I go to the 26th, make a phone call, or whatever it is I'm doing, however I'm collecting data. So you see what this does, this helps ensure that all of my data gets spread out. One of the problems of simple random sample is, remember that the very first simple random sample is number 1, 2, and 3. Well, that has an equal likelihood of being chosen as anything else. However, you could get clumping like that. And if there's something special going on in your population where different types of people are clumped together, you could over or underrepresent groups by using a simple random sample because you could get that clumping. Where this systematic one in K helps ensure that, or as a matter of fact, it guarantees that your data will be spread out throughout your entire population. And unless there's some other hidden pattern that we don't realize, this will avoid the whole idea of possibly clumping data together and getting a misrepresentation.